The title is On Love This Morning. But before we get there, let's go to the Heavenly Father. Lord, thank you for the assembled body that you have given us. Thank you for our mother church in Phoenix, Arizona. And Lord, most especially, thank you for your love that comes through your only Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, thank you for this beautiful day and everything you have blessed us with. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Are you living in love? Mark 12:29-33. That's Mark 12:29-33. And Jesus answered him, "The first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord." Verse 30 says, "Thou shalt love thy Lord, the Lord thy God, with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment." Verse 31 says, "And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these." 32 says, "And the scribe said unto him, Well, Master, thou hast said the truth, for there is one God, and there is none other but he. And to love him with all your heart, with all the understanding, and with all the soul, and with all strength, and to love his neighbor as himself, is more than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices."
What was that scripture?
Mark 12:29-33. Love is the sweetest thing that you can have in Jesus Christ. His love never leaves us or forsakes us. Hebrews 13:5. "Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he had said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee." I will never ever forsake you. Jesus uses the same technique to express certainty of eternal life for believers. John 10:18. That's John 10:18. Oh, sorry, that's John 10:28. Sorry. That's John 10:28. "And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither should any man pluck them out of my Father's hands. For what may give, I will never lose." Jesus shows us how to love when you have faith and you believe. Love is the greatest gift from God that we can have. We love because he first loved us. 1 John 4:19. That's 1 John 4:19. We love him because he first loved us. It's the most wonderful, amazing feeling that our Lord gives you. When you believe in Jesus Christ and his word about love, also, if you have love, you have God. If you say you love God and hate your brother, he's a liar, and the love of the Father is not in you. 1 John 4:20. That's 1 John 4:20. "If a man says, I love God and hate his brother, he is a liar. For he that loveth not his brother, whom he had seen, how can he love God, whom he had not seen?" This is what I found love to be in the Bible. 1 John 4:10. That's 1 John 4:10. "Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be a propitiation for our sins." The word propitiation means substitute or taking place of another. Our love is made perfect in Jesus Christ. He gives us boldness in the day of judgment, not doubting, 1 John 4:17. That's 1 John 4:17. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as he is, so are we in this world. One of the best feelings in the world is without question love. We fall into it, we seek it out, we cherish it, and we share it. Love is an expression that everyone can understand regardless of who they are. Love is power, is a powerful emotion. That true love comes from Jesus Christ himself. 1 Peter 4:8. That's 1 Peter 4:8. And above all things, have fervent charity. Charity is another word for love, among yourselves. For charity shall cover the multitude of sin. Peter is not suggesting that one Christian's love atones for another Christian's sin. Rather, by introducing this proverb from the Old Testament, he is reminding us that love does not stir up sin. We can demonstrate our love for our fellow believers by truly forgiving them and not talking openly about their past sins. Proverbs 10:12. That's Proverbs 10:12. Hatred stirs up strife, but love love covers all sins. When you are in love, there is no fear, just perfect love. 1 John 4:18. That's 1 John 4:18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. The word torment means something that causes extreme suffering. Love is when you choose to beat your best when the other person is not at their best. 1 John 4:7-8. That's 1 John 4:7-8. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone that love is born and knoweth of God. Verse 8 says, he that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. 1 John 3:10-11. 1 John 3:10-11. In this the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil. Whosoever doeth not righteous is not of God, neither he that loveth not his brother. Verse 11 says, for this is the message that ye heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. 1 John 3:23. 1 John 3:23. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he gave us commandment. 1 John 4:11. That's 1 John 4:11. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. Matthew 18:33. That's Matthew 18:33. Shouldest not thou also have had compassion on thy fellow servant, even as I have had pity on thee? Love your enemies. Matthew 5:44-45. That's Matthew 5:44-45. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good. good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despisefully use you and prosecute you. Verse 45, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven, for he makes his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. The greatest gift that we can have is when one lays down their own life for his friends. John 15:13. That's John 15:13. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. 1 John 3:16. 1 John 3:16. Hereby perceive we the love of God, because he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brethren. To love does not mean to agree with someone's sin, or to say that everything that they do is okay. Rather, it's to bear with them, to pray for them, to have faith for them, to want the very best for them. There are no exceptions to love. No, well, this person doesn't deserve it. Jesus laid down his life for us, the ultimate sign of how much he means. Jesus Christ has loved us, and no one has ever been less deserving than we are of that. Love, not hate. Love is what draws people near or close. So if I feel that I'm lacking true godly love, then I can pray to God that he can show me how I can get more love from him, Jesus Christ. I need to be willing to give up my own self-will and think of others before myself. True love. True love never fails, it's not rude, it has no evil. It rejoices in the truth. For 1 Corinthians 13:4-8. 1 Corinthians 13:4-8. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Verse 6, love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. Verse 7 says it always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always preserves. Verse 8, love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. Are you loving one another as Jesus forgave you? By learning the truth in Jesus Christ, you should love one another. Love to me means being caring, kind, sweet, gentle, joyful, and love. These are all of God. Jesus Christ has shown me what true love really is. Thank you, Jesus, on showing me love. By learning the truth in love is 1 Corinthians 13:13. That's 1 Corinthians 13:13. And now abide faith, hope, and charity, these three. But the greatest of these is charity, meaning love. My favorite verse in God's word is this, 1 Corinthians 13:4-8. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It's not puffed up. 5, does not behave rudely. Does not seek its own. Is not provoked. Thinks no evil. Verse 6, does not rejoice in iniquities, but rejoices in the truth. Verse 7, bears all things, believes all things, hope all things, endures all things. In verse 8, love never fails, but where there are tongues, they will cease. Where there is knowledge, it will vanish away. And my message continues still. I have a song for you guys to listen to.